Let's take a look at what goes on behind the scenes while producing a video for Tom's Trains and Things. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And today we're going to go behind the scenes of how I produce my videos. I'm going to show you how I set everything up and how I do some of the things on the computer. And while I'm taping this right here, I have my tablet further back taping the whole thing. They used to call it filming stuff, and then it was taping stuff. But now when you're using digital, what do you say? So I'm just going to say producing a video or hashtag SD the video. If you're new to model railroading or a closet, attic, or storage model railroader, and you kept everything packed up in boxes since you was a kid, then this place is for you. If you started a model railroad early in life and put it away, hung your layout up on a wall like I did, and life got in the way and you want to return to it, then this place is for you. If you thought you never had enough room or never had enough money, then this place is for you. If you thought you didn't have enough skills, then this place is for you. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and click on that little bell. You'll be notified whenever I upload a video. And so you'll be the first to know if you hit that little bell. That's why I'm asking you to subscribe. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and hit that bell, because you'll learn stuff here. All those reasons that I gave you in the beginning are good, valid reasons to watch. Here's a behind the scenes view of my train room and how I record everything. Now, alright, this is where I set up the tripod right here. Okay, and as you can see, it's right at the top of the stairwell. And I used to have it back the other way. I used to be on this side, but I kept on backing up and running into the train, and you could see, I don't know if you could, from a couple of different videos that I did, heard that. Okay, this is a Bogan tripod that we got at the Lions Club thrift store. It was originally marked for $11, and I told Debbie that it's missing the top, the quick release for the camera. So she went and talked to the guy and got it down to $9. So that's a pretty good tripod for $9. And then this other one here, we got at a church sale for $5. It's, what brand is that? I don't know what brand it is. But anyway, anytime you buy a tripod, it's always missing the quick release for the camera. And I didn't bother getting one for that. I just use this for the lights. And I have two clamp-on lights. I have one facing at me and one facing at the back wall. And the same thing on this side. I got a 1x2 clamp to the layout. And I got one facing at me and one facing at the back wall. And there is the monitor that I use. It's a Vizio television. And this is my camera right here. NEX-5. We bought this long, long time ago. I had a camera, and I guess, I can't remember, two of our camera, we was at Disney World and on our way up to Maryland, and two of our cameras died at Disney World, so we ended up buying a Nikon Coolpix. And then later on when we got up to Maryland, we bought this thing here. That was about 7 years ago. That's the stand for my microphone. I got a blue Yeti. That was the only new thing that I got up until today. And I ordered it through Amazon, and I should have ordered it through my website. Okay, but here's my laptop. This is an old Dell laptop. And I can't do, I don't have it on right now, but anyway, that's where I plug in the microphone and record. I accidentally shut the thing off, But that's my tripod. It's a Slick. I bought that in 1976, and it's still in good shape. I mean, you can't buy tripods like that anymore. I mean, that thing is solid. But anyway, and here's my area where I talk. And we got this for about $12 or so at that place. And I like that. That's like me when I was a little kid. But anyway, this is the clamp that I got. I bought that at Hobby Lobby on the clearance sale for like $8. That's supposed to be on the headrest of a car. So you can put your tablet on the headrest, and I bent a little aluminum rod so I can use that. I use that for my at the workbench, and I use it for here also. And I've used it in some other videos. I clamped it up against one of these tripods and used it the tablet as a second camera. Before I start each video, I get Vegas Pro 11 ready on here, and I put an audio track in there. I connect up my microphone, and then I arm the video track, and I have a folder where I do all my audios for all my videos. This is my camera. It's an NEX5 Sony. This thing is six or seven years old. Okay, and I can't use it for that long of a period, because if I keep it on for too long, it overheats, and I get this little red flashing thing on there. And I did that on one video. I was doing a video, and I was using this monitor right here, and I was seeing a flashing. But anyway, I have to set up my tripod. I have it set up. I got it jammed down in between a tote and the wall right there, and I got it up against my layout right here, and that's how I know I have it in the same place every time, and I don't move any of these right here. And I just put my camera up in here like this on the quick release and set it there. I use the television as a monitor. Clamp that down and hold it on there tight. Now, as long as I don't have the television on, it'll show up back here. As soon as I turn the television on, it'll show up on the television. And every time it comes on, what I have to do is, it says unable to display, so I got to do it on here because it goes to the last video or the last picture that I took. Now I have all these lights up here, these clamp-on lights. I have four of them that I use. Put all these lights on also. Make sure you got good lighting. And I always set this up pretty close to the same spot. And I make sure the back wall is lit up good too, because that makes the video look a lot better. And then I come over here and I see if I need to adjust the lighting any. See this one over here, it's kind of bright on my, right there.
but that's because it's so close. But I usually have that one and this one right here. This one I gotta bring down, point down a little bit. Yeah, that's a lot better. And see, with the back wall lit up, it makes the video itself look a lot better. Because when the background is dark, it just makes the whole video look dark. So you gotta make sure the background is lit up pretty well. And I have this ready to go. And the camera's ready to go. And what I have to do is I have to sneak back here because I don't have that much room to turn the camera on. Okay. Gravely Building 4, and that's running. So I turn the audio on. And that's to sync everything up, the audio with that and the audio with this here. All right. Gravely Building, the fourth video. We're going to talk about the floors. I'm going to notch the floors out, and hopefully we're going to get to primering it today. I got about 21 and a half, 22 minutes of video already, so let's get started with this right now, see what's going on. And that's where the break goes in, and then I go... I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This... and I messed it up. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And on that railroad, we need structures, we need scenery, we need everything. And that's why I'm putting together this Gravely Building. And I got almost 22 minutes of it filmed already, of just notching out the wood and getting it ready for priming. So let's get started with it. Let's not hesitate anymore, and we'll get started on the video right now. Okay, now we'll come up to the end part. That's all we got for right now. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you learned something from it. And if you haven't done so already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. You know why? Because it's free. And you get to learn stuff when you watch my videos. And right next to the subscribe button, there's a little bell. And I put the ding in there. There's a little bell. Click on that, and that'll notify you whenever I have a video. And leave a comment down below. I read all the comments, I respond to all the comments, and if you want to, you could communicate with the other creators who comment on the videos also. You don't have to just comment on me, you could comment on their comments also. And I have a PayPal me right here. It costs money to do these videos. And as you can see, I have cheap things on here. Well, you'll be able to see it on my next video that's coming out, because I'm doing a behind the scenes. And right now I'm taping it with my tablet that's sitting up there on the wall. And I'll turn this thing around afterwards and I'll show you where the tablet is, and you'll be able to see that part on the behind the scenes video, which is coming out in a couple of days. But anyway, check out my webpage. Okay, I told you I was going to be putting some photos in there, and I'm going to be doing that right after I finish this video here. I'm going to be working on a webpage. I made a couple of changes on it this week already, but I'm going to be putting some photos up there on there for Colorado Model Railroad Museum. I got a little bit of video, and I got a little bit of a lot of pictures. Debbie took a lot of pictures. She took a lot of videos also. The videos are from my little Nikon Coolpix, which is a little 5200 thing. It's just a little camera. And from our cell phone. We didn't have this camera here or the or the tablet to take any videos when we were there. So it's just, kind of crude stuff, but that's coming up. And, okay, I told you about the web page and all that stuff, and we'll see you. I got this one. I got more videos for the Gravely building and the, and the behind the scenes video, which will be coming out in a couple of days. So, we'll see you. And then do. Okay, now shut the camera off, shut the audio off. Say done. Okay, all the dialogue is done for that video of the Gravely building. So what I'm going to do, I'll turn the television off. And you see it comes back up there. I'll shut this off for a second. Unplug that. And turn this back on, and I'll take a little video of, let's see if we can get that to focus in on there. Alright. Oops, the light's in the way. Okay, there's the tablet. I got it up on the edge of my layout. I got it propped up in there to take the video of the behind the scenes, which this part is going to be in the behind the scenes video. And I'll turn around here, and that's what that part looks like. There we go. I got almost 11 minutes on there. Okay, I already took it out. I took the battery out because it needs charging up. And this is a little SD card. What I do is I put that on the computer, and that's what I got the video from. And this laptop right here, it has the audio is in a WAV file. So all I do is when I go into my main computer, I just upload the or download or whatever it is, upload or download. I just transfer the file from here, put it over there, and I work on it in Audacity on that. I'll put this on the charger for right now. And could save this. I could shut this program off anyway. Leave the laptop on. Stick this in my pocket. And put all this stuff back. It's a lot to go through for the videos, but I like doing this. And I'm going to show you some of the stuff that I do on the computer also. So when I shut this off, you'll be able to see, and say you can't see it, but Sadie's over here licking my leg while I'm talking. What are you doing, huh? What? Give me. There you go. Here's Sadie. Say hi. Mm-hmm. Say hi. Yeah, what is that, huh? You wanted to see what's going on over here, huh? Yeah. Okay. There you go. All right. Now, this is all new. I just got this today. It's the flexible arm for a microphone, the shock mount for a Blue Yeti, and the pop filter, or the pop screen. And I just set it up temporarily here on my desk. And then we went to Goodwill, and Debbie found this chair for $6.99. And the only thing that was wrong with it, it had a vibrator on it, and the vibrator doesn't work, so I guess that's why they got rid of it. And here's my workstation.
And I'm actually editing this video right now. Well, actually, I'm replacing one of the clips because I took a clip with a cell phone, and it when I have the front-facing camera, or no, the back, or when I'm pointing like this anyway, it has a hum in the left speaker. So I'm replacing that video with this one here, and see, that's where I started this video.
Okay. I normally have my playback video on the other monitor, but since I'm doing this all on the one screen, I'm going to put it over here, and I'm going to have to move my move this over. So that's, I'll put it up right there. That's out of the way. Now, I just recorded some stuff on the on my tablet, because some of these clips over here were from my well, not that one, this one here. Now this one here, this one, and this one I recorded with my cell phone, an old cell phone. But when I recorded it with the front-facing camera, it made a humming noise in a left speaker. So I'm going to get rid of these, and I redid them in the video, and you're going to see these videos because this is what I'm going to take out. And I also know that there's some model railroaders that are using Vegas to edit their videos. I know Vinny's one. I'm not sure. I think Mark from M&M Rails is another one. Vinny has Vegas 11 Pro, and I'm not sure which one Mark has. But anyway, I know you're not using it to your full potential, and I'm going to show you a little bit of things over here. Now, just to get rid of a clip, okay, you can go up here, right-click on it, and cut. Use your shortcut keys or shortcut keys to get rid of the things. Okay, but anyway, I'm going to replace those three with the ones that I just recorded. Now, there was 917. Okay, that's this one here. Now, you're going to get a little bit of an echo. Well, let me turn the microphone off for a second, so, because you're going to get an echo when this thing plays. So I'll just turn it off for a second. I accidentally. All right, this is where I set up the tripod right here. Okay, and as you can see, it's right at the top of the stairwell. I accidentally shut the thing off, but that's my tripod. It's a Slick. Now, this is all new. I just got this today. Okay, the microphone's back on. So I put those three clips in there. Now, you could do it either with the plus or the minus down here, but as long as you're someplace on the timeline, you could use your mouse and scroll this to make it larger. And what it's going to do is going to put the cursor right in the middle of your timeline. So if you move your cursor over here and scroll, it's going to move it over so your cursor is right in the middle of the timeline. And with this tablet, you'll see that the video, on this one here, the video was cut off, or the audio cut off right before the video ended. Now normally it's the opposite. I'll come over here, and you could see here where the audio is a little bit longer. So you could trim this down just by holding the mouse, and you could shorten your video clip. Now I know some of you, because I've seen you go up and, you know, reach for your camera to
to shut off the thing, and you could see that in your video. But you could eliminate that by just going to the end over here, and all you have to do is do that, click your left mouse button down, and then pull it in, and that'll shorten the clip, and you could bring it to anywhere you want to. So I'm going to have to move my camera up to get on the let me see which one's the camera. Okay, shift. Okay, I'll put that over there to get over here. Now this is going to echo a little bit because you're going to hear the audio from the computer, and it's going to come back onto the microphone here.
This video.
Okay, so I'll bring it all the way back to where it ended, and you could trim it down like that. Okay, and another thing, you could fade as much as you want, as long as you have, you know, you get that little arc thing right there that says fade. Okay, and another, you could change the way the fade is. Now this is a quick fade. You right click up there and you could change it, or you could right click on the audio clip and go up to fade type, and you'll get the same thing. All right, now here's something that I did earlier. Okay, I took a video clip and I inserted it up in here. Okay, and you could see that part right there is this clip right here, and I put it right above the main clip, which is this one right here. So you click on this, left click on that, event pan crop, you left click on that, and you get your screen up here for pan crop. Click on it somewhere and then use your mouse wheel to bring it down. Okay, if you don't have a mouse wheel, you could use the minus and plus right there. But see this, I could move it up and down like that. Okay, and that prevents me from moving it horizontally. Okay, I could click on that, and I can move that anyway like that. Or if I only want to do it this way, see, I can't move it that way. So I'll put it right back up here. Okay, I'll move it over just a little bit right there, and I want to move it above this building and up close to that, so I'll do it like that and just bring it, move this and bring it up just a little bit, so it's not quite at the top, and you can see the top of this building right here. Maybe I'll do it just a little bit more. There we go. Now you can see the space in there. So that's just a couple of tips on that. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to record in the morning. I'm going to record a dialogue for the beginning and after the splash screen, and then for the end of the video. Now I'm right here in the middle of the video and I want to go to the end, so I just go click on that, and that takes me all the way to the end. Okay, and I can go all the way back to the beginning again. Now I expanded that with my mouse wheel, but you could stretch out the timeline with the mouse wheel, or you could crunch it in to as far as it'll go in, and this is as far as it'll go in, and what it'll do no matter how big your clip is, if you have like 5 minutes or even if you have 15 minutes of clips there, where it compresses it all the way down, it's going to show that full 15 minutes. Or if you have only 5 minutes, it's going to show that 5 minutes. But then you could stretch it out past that after that. Okay, because it'll open up like this. See, this is the end of the last clip right there, which is, I'll bring this out here, which is 20 minutes and 48 seconds. But I have some dead space over here. Excuse me, where I'm going to add my dialogue, and I'm going to add some more back here. So what I could do, see this one, auto ripple. Now on the version that I have, it has this on the bottom, but on the older versions, it has it up here on your menu bar up on the top. Now what that does is I'm going to bring my cursor over here and make it a little bit bigger, make that clip a little bit bigger. But what you can do is, click down on my left mouse button and I move it. Now I can move it anywhere, and it's going to move all the clips behind it. Now there's a down arrow to the right of it, and it's auto ripple. You could also do the same thing with Control L. Okay, now I have it for all tracks, markers, and regions. You can also do affected track, bus tracks, markers, and region, and affected tracks. Okay, if you just do affected tracks and you click on here, it's only going to move what's on these two tracks here if these two tracks are in a group. If you have anything, I have two additional video tracks above this for my text. So if you just, I'll just show you what it does. Affected tracks. Okay, affected tracks is clicked. So what I'll do here, and this is in a group right here, so that's not a good example. But anyway, I'll just put it back to where it was, because that's not a good example because I don't have any text up here right now. Let me put some text up here. I'll just put one of these right here. Okay, so that says time. I have some default things up here. So affected tracks. So I'll do this, and it still moves it. Okay, never mind. And it's only supposed to do that when all tracks. But see, if you have a marker over here, I'm going to put a marker like right here. By clicking M. You can click M and it'll put a marker someplace. And that's if you want to leave yourself some notes when you're shutting it off and you want to edit it a little bit later on, then you could put these markers in here to remind you, and then you could always move them someplace else by left clicking on it and moving it. But anyway, I'll put that marker in there, and all tracks, markers, and regions. So I'll click on this and drag it, and it's supposed to and it'll take the marker with it. Now if I all affected tracks and I move this, it's going to leave the marker right where it's at. So what I always do is I always keep it on all tracks, markers, and regions, and move it like that so it moves the marker with it. See, I moved the marker back there. A lot of times you'll end up doing editing and you'll add something like, now I still have this on right here, and I'll put something right here. And what it's going to do is going to move my whole timeline back because I had that still clicked in. Now let me undo that. Okay, I'll take this off. unclick that and put this down here. And see, it'll leave it there. It won't move my timeline, because that, when that's clicked in, that'll move everything behind what you put in there. And sometimes I have that on, I forget that I have it on, and I'll put some text down there and it'll move everything back. So what I have to do is I have to go up here and undo media, drop in tracks, boom, I just took it out of there. And anytime you have a session, it'll keep track of all your stuff in there in the undo, and you can go down and undo everything you did in that track, in that session that you're working in at the time. So I'm going to stop this right now and add this to the back of the video. But before I do that, I'm going to move this over here a little bit. Oops. See what it does? I don't have it on, so it just moved that one clip. So I'll turn it on and move this down, and it moves everything over, including the markers. And I'll shut it off. I'll save this, and then I'm going to shut this video off and add it to the end of this video. And by the way, the screen capture that I got it when it came with the video card that I got. I don't know if you remember, but I was doing a video, and I put it out late, and I said, you know, that my video card messed up, and I had to go out and get another video card. Well, I ended up getting another NVIDIA card, but it's not that compatible with Sony Vegas. And I started reading up, and I found out that AMD is a better card for Sony Vegas. And it's a lot cheaper. This one has 8 GB memory in it, and it was half the price of an NVIDIA card that had only 2 MB of memory, or 2 GB of memory. So I was getting 4 times the memory, and that's memory of the video chip, not the memory of your CPU. It's the GPU memory. So it works a lot better in Sony Vegas if you have an AMD card. And a long time ago, it was just the opposite. I always had an NVIDIA card in there, and it worked really good. But since, you know, as they went on doing the updates, you know, my system was slower now, because when I bought this, I had Sony Vegas 10. Now they're up to 14. So, you know, this is an old computer, but when I bought it with a lot of memory, and I bought 12 GB of memory in it, of RAM, and I bought the best video. I took the video card that came with it. It was an AMD card, and it didn't work that good, so I went and bought an NVIDIA card and put it in there, and that one just crapped out a couple of months ago. But anyway, you know, let me cut this off. You don't want to hear all that stuff.
I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you learned something from it, from watching behind the scenes. It takes a lot of work to produce these videos, and I just wanted to show you, you know, what's involved in it. And I'm going to ask you, if you want more instructions on editing and with Vegas, because I have Vegas, that's the only one I have, or Audacity for the audio. So, nope. I always point to the wrong place. I'm going to do a survey. So click on the survey and tell me if you want more videos instructing you on how to do Vegas or Audacity. Go ahead and hit that little survey button up there and answer yes or yes, I want to see more. No, I don't want to see it, or not, you know, don't care. The last survey that I did came overwhelmingly, yes, you want to see more of that stuff. I think it came out to like 79% yes and 8% I don't care. So, you know, that, you know, over 80% of yes, we want to see it. Go ahead and see the website down there. By now, I should have put more photos in there of Colorado Model Railroad Museum. And if you haven't done so already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and hit that little bell that's wherever it is. I think it's down here next to the subscribe button. Anyway, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the little bell to be notified of when I produce a video. Check out my PayPal Me account. It costs money to do these videos, and you have seen some of the things that I go through in producing these videos. That's not all of it, but I have more. But go ahead, if you'd like to support this channel, do the PayPal Me. You could also do it on a web page. On the bottom of it, I have a little support button on there that takes you to the PayPal Me account. So go ahead and do that. Also, give me a thumbs up. Share this video and leave some comments down there. I have the comments down here. See this little thing right here? Leave some comments. I read all your comments. I love all your comments. And you could comment between each other on there also. Next weekend, I'll have my new Model Railroader for Beginners video out. So take a look for that on next Saturday. I don't know what the date is, but you know, I'll put it up here on the screen what that date is, and I'll have it out at 10 o'clock in the morning. Maybe I might change the schedule a little bit and put it out later in the day. I'm not sure yet, but anyway, look for it next Saturday. So we'll see you. Take care, and don't forget to click on this little thing over here, and my webpage is right here, and I'll have some videos right over here. So we'll see you.